everyone, and welcome back. Today I have a remodel for you and a request. Rocio, and I hope I'm pronouncing your name correctly, asked me to make a house where one person lives that's two stories with a guest room. And I absolutely have always loved the snow chalet as long as we've had it, and I've remodeled it once on my channel, but I just wanted to do it again because we have all of these beautiful new items, and I kept thinking how wonderful they would look in the snow chalet. So if you've been with me a while, then you know when I do remodels, I don't change the walls. This is one of those houses that's already just pretty. So even if you take everything out of it, the structure itself is just beautiful. So you're looking at the entryway here. And I will say I love the new carpets that I got in the online store. They are very beautiful. There are a lot of neutral tones in there, and it was definitely worth the money to me to pay that. But I kept the stairs where they were, and you'll notice I kept the same style of windows and doorways. I did change around a lot of the windows, though, just because I don't really like how they had some of them placed. This is the new great room, so I put some of the new furniture in here. I am in love with these sofas. They are definitely my favorite in the game so far. I think they're just beautiful. And I opened up the walls just a little bit more. I took out the A-frame windows upstairs, which you'll see in a minute, but I just wanted to make it as open as I could because I love the views on this lot. No matter what side of the house you're on, you have gorgeous views of the snow. So you can see here what I've done with these new archways. I've put one on either side, and then I've put a bar in the middle. So it still looks open to the kitchen, but it just looks a lot more stylish and put together. There is so much we can do with those new archways. And you can see the bar there in the center that's decorated with a couple of plants on either side. So I changed out the dining room furniture with the new, except you'll notice the table is still the black chalet table. So I just brought in the black chalet table, and look how pretty those new chairs look with that. That's what I'm loving about the new items that we've gotten from really the past 5 or 6 updates, is that you can take a lot of these items, even if you don't win or unlock all of them and you just get some of them, and put them with the older items in the game, and they're really going nicely in these houses. So, of course, here's the kitchen. It was already here like this, but I did change out a lot of the appliances. I changed the layout of it just a little bit. I love that big stainless steel stove. And then, of course, there's the bar here. I put a dishwasher in and a trash can and just decorated it different than what they had it before. But I really like how this whole great room, dining room, and kitchen turned out. It's not exactly the way they had it. I even changed out the fireplace, but I love these archways and how you can just use these almost anywhere. I'm really glad that they made them freestanding because you can really do a lot with them. I'm thinking about playing around with them and trying to make different room shapes with them. I haven't done that yet, but that's definitely on my list of things to try out. So the bathroom was already here. I just redecorated it completely. I changed the flooring and the wallpaper, used some of the hotel suite items there, along with the farmhouse mirror on the wall, and just changed the placement of some of the windows. Again, they had them placed kind of weird in the house in some spots, so I just straightened them up and made them make more sense in each room. And I have that little divider there with the toilet there in the corner. And I've also just included a towel rack and one of the white chalet rugs. So now it's a beautiful bathroom. I thought before it was a little dark in there, so I wanted to brighten it up and use items with just a little bit more contrast. So you'll see that's an overview of the first floor redecorated. Now we're going to come up the stairs to the landing that was already here. I just included a bookshelf, and you'll notice there's a door here that wasn't here before. That's one of the things I didn't like, was that the second bedroom upstairs didn't have access to a bathroom. So when we take a look at the bathroom, you'll see that I made a way for the person who's staying in the guest room to use the bathroom upstairs. The other thing you'll notice is I took the landing that was originally here off and put it into my inventory, and instead dropped in a mezzanine. That way I could make a larger loft up there for more living space. And I also took out those A-frame windows and matched them up with the 4 square wide windows that were at the bottom. So now you have more living space up here. Now that I took the landing out and just added a mezzanine and made a loft here. and you'll see the sofa there with the chairs and the ottoman and the side tables. So I've kind of put this together. The ottoman goes with a different set. The rug, I believe, is from the pool house update. Then there are French tables as side tables and just white chairs and a couch here. So again, you can put these items together and really make them look nice. So you can see over there also by the window are a couple of little pet beds. We have the bookshelves and the TV and one of the newer trees. So just a family entertainment area there. The couple I'm going to move in here does not have any children. I'm going to keep this house for a while. I have a couple that I'm definitely going to move in here, and they do have a pug. But look how pretty those new flowers go with this bedspread. This is one of my favorite bedroom sets anyway. I love the finish on the wood. And you can see they have the picture of their pug there. And that candle arrangement also goes very, very well with that bedspread too. So that is the newly decorated master suite. And you can also see here I've added those pink chairs with a matching table at the foot of the bed and another one of those flowers. So that pink actually goes with some of the little flowers in the bedspread. And that's something people often ask me, is how I put all these colors together. I try to look for some of the small details in things and then put something bigger that matches them in the room, if that makes sense, kind of drawing out colors. So there's where I put the door, so the second bedroom, whoever is in there would have access to the upstairs bath. And I did put a washing machine in here. There's not room for a laundry room in here. Well, if you change the walls, you could definitely put one, but I don't do that. So I just put a washer in there, and we can just pretend that it's a washer and dryer combo. And I've used the spa items in here. Also that farmhouse towel rack, which goes really well with several of the bathroom sets that we have. And just a toilet paper holder over there as well. I kept the wallpaper and flooring the same upstairs, but again, I did change it downstairs. I didn't put a tub in here because we do have that large tub downstairs in that bathroom. So coming across the loft here, we come into the guest room, which is what the subscriber request is, that we have a guest room in here. So I kind of made it a double purpose room. We have the guest bed here and a dresser for them. You can see the suitcases over there in the corner, right there. And just some lamps and side tables, some of the newer items. And also, it's a home office. So I put a desk in here, just a computer desk, where the homeowner can come in here and get some work done. And that is the second floor remodel. The thing about this house is, yes, it's beautiful, but there are not a lot of rooms. So when you remodel it, most people change walls and add rooms and all of that. And like I said, there's so much you can do with it, but there's just not a lot of rooms. There's a lot of open space. So it's definitely tricky if you don't change walls to make it into a family home. But I thought it would be absolutely perfect for this request because it was requested that it be a single person and then just have a guest room. And I immediately thought of the snow chalet, particularly because I had been wanting to remodel it anyway with the newer items. So now we're gonna take a look at where I put everything, just the furniture, because we don't need to do the grid where it's a remodel. So that's the newly decorated great room. Again, I'm not a huge fan of those huge couches. A lot of people like them, so I was glad to change them out with the newer ones. And I love this feature here with the double archways and the bar in the middle. And then that is the newly decorated dining area and kitchen. And of course, there's the entryway there. I think it looks much brighter now. And the new bathroom downstairs. And then the landing is pretty much the same. I just added a bookshelf and a doorway for extra access to the bathroom. And then I took out that landing upstairs and just added a mezzanine there so we could have the living area in the loft. And this is how the master bedroom looks now. And the new bathroom. I did leave that wall and flooring alone though. And a lot of the wallpaper, the gray, I did keep in the home. So thank you so much, Rocio. And again, I hope I'm pronouncing your name correctly. Please let me know in the comments if I didn't. I hope everyone enjoyed the remodel and the tour. If you did, please hit that like button. I sure do appreciate it. Thank you so very much for watching. I hope everyone's doing well. Take care, and I will see you next time.